And from there, I started to try to figure out where I wanted to be in this industry. I ended up landing in barbering as well, because I'm a barber. Also, at this point, my focus is natural hair. I used to do relaxers, jerry curls, you name it. We've come through the whole shebang. I've seen it all too, okay? From the natural to the curls to the relaxed, now back to the natural. So my thing is though, now I noticed just through all of that, I sat down and I really started to realize that, wait a minute, this actually has a purpose, you know? Me learning all that stuff, not willingly, learning all those things actually put me in a position right now with this natural hair movement, they say, put me in a position to be able to empower people, other women, other stylists. And so I'm so grateful to be here at the Show Me International Hair Show. So y'all make some noise at least for that, for being able to be here. How you guys doing? All right, perfect. So the thing is, now we're at this natural hair movement. How did I get here? I gave my very last relaxer about 10 years ago. The reason why is because I had seen so many women with these trends of fibroid tumors, not only that, balding. I saw so many different things taking place, and I also started to realize, well, maybe there's a connection in some way, you know. I also noticed that there were trends of me, or periods where I wasn't given relaxers at all. You know, me growing up in a salon, I didn't have time to work on my own head a lot of time. If you're a stylist, first of all, make some noise. If you're a hairstylist, yeah. How often do you get to work on your own head? Not at all, right? So we find ways to stretch our styles, to make our styles do things. We find ways to make it work. And people always say, man, your hair looks so nice, what'd you do? Now, keep in mind, during that time period, straightening your hair was really popular. So a lot of us ended up learning how to flat iron and straighten hair without chemicals before it was really popular to do so. Am I right? So that was the thing with me. I ended up doing a lot of those techniques. As we started moving towards the natural movement, without even thinking about it, I said, you know, I want to put this relaxer to the side. I'm going to start treating my clients' hair like I was treating mine. The reason I did that was because I realized that my hair grew out a lot faster. It seemed like it was just growing so fast, you know. But I had to realize that that was nothing but my hair staying on my head, all right? And actually learning more and more. We'll get into that later. But right now, I want to ask a couple of stylists to come to the stage, and I'm going to just break down a little bit more. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for my cohort, but also my brother, Leonardo Price, and a good friend of mine, Mr. Bob Thomas. Put your hands together. Y'all give me a shout louder. Get your hands together and come to the stage. Okay, perfect. So I wanted them to come to the stage because I've actually, not only, I'm a barber as well, but I've actually expanded myself by not only focusing on natural hair and learning more about natural hair, but also building a product line, okay? So I started a product line. The name of my company is Healthy Hair Solutions. My very first product was called Whisper Whip. And with that, I learned how to do so many things. I learned about moisturization versus hydration and understanding how those work in company with natural hair, how it's such a huge, huge component of working with natural hair clients. And let me just say this. A client is a client. Natural, whatever they are, they're a client. And there is no way to really separate them except for educating yourself, okay? Educating yourself. Any stylist can do what I'm doing. When I stopped giving relaxers, I was told, are you crazy? You're gonna lose money. In my mind, I said, girl, you crazy? You're gonna lose money. Then I thought to myself, it's gonna take all day to do somebody's hair that's that thick and nappy and blah, blah, you know, all those things. But I also committed to understanding that, first of all, God does not make mistakes. When He created us, we were designed very, 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 very beautifully. And the texture that comes out of our head was created that way for a reason. I didn't understand it at the time, but I did commit myself to saying, you know what, I'm gonna get to know what it is and why our hair was created and curled that way. So let me get to understand that. In doing and committing to that, I learned so much. I also tell you that I thought I was gonna lose clientele. My clientele went so crazy that I can't even take any more customers. What I'm doing now is actually training other stylists to become hair whisperers, if that's what you want to call them. That's just the whisper brand that was born. We have one here, raise your hand, it's Miss Jasmine. She's a natural hairstylist as well. We have another young man that's going to be whisper stylist as well, Torin, raise your hand. Also, we have whisper stylist Leonardo on stage, he's one. Bob Thomas, raise your hand. They all are whisperers. So these are people that are traveling all over the country teaching other stylists techniques that I've learned and picked up behind the chair that you can incorporate with what you've been doing as well, okay? So I'm gonna take you through a typical day of mine, all right? Here we go. This is Miss Shannon Hoskins. Hi Shannon, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good. I see you've got some things going on. Tell me about your day.
Well,
tell me what you're doing.
Basically, you know,
give me 1 second, let me mic you, hold on. Here you go.
So basically, you know, in a day, I have a really busy day. I'm a very busy working woman, also a stylist. So, you know, a lot of time with us being stylists, we like to lean on the extensions and things of that nature.
Okay. So are you natural?
Well, I'm natural, yeah, definitely.
Okay. So tell me some of your struggles you're having with your natural. Do you like it? I mean, what's going on with your natural?
I love it, but, you know, a lot of times I'm finding problems with having dryness. So.
Okay, yeah. Let's stop right there. How many of you all heard this conversation before? Okay? I'm gonna take you to step two. Well, Shannon, is it okay if we, is this a sew-in or what do you have going on here?
Well, actually, it's a wig because again, you know, I don't have time for all that.
Okay. It's a wig, okay. Well, can we take it off? Are you okay?
Sure, you can.
Right, I'm gonna take it off. All right, let's stop here. How many of you have seen this before? How many of you all at this point feel like, oh Lord? You feel like, oh Lord? I wish you guys could feel, and actually, I'm gonna open this. Can we get together? If you wanna come up and touch her hair, and this is a client straight out of a wig, straight out of no preparation or anything like that, I want you guys to be able to see and feel what I do. So if you would like to come on the stage and touch and feel, please do. Her hair, yeah. She's just out of braids that were plaited down. There's, you know how we get our clients. It's like, whoa, wait a minute. DJ, I like